the last day of Julan Yatra. So when we finish the class, we'll be having, you can see we have the small swing here. The deities of Radha and Krishna will be placed on the swing, and everybody can take an opportunity to push the swing.
So now we have done the class,
so now it's the auspicious month of Shravan. In this month, of course, there's many festivals. We have Balaram's appearance day today, and then next week is Janmashtami, and then 2 weeks later, the appearance day of Srimati Radharani, or Radhastami.
So, 主 Krishna 的显现日，然后之后的两个星期呢，是圣 Radha Rani 的显现。
So we want to speak today about the glories of Lord Balaram.
我们今天要来讲述一下这个圣 Balaram 的荣耀。
We see Lord Balaram here along with his younger brother Lord Jagannath or Lord Krishna and his sister Subhadra.
我们看到上面最大的神像呢，有主。Jagannath, 还有他的哥哥 Balaram, 还有妹妹呢 Subhadra 在这上面。
So Lord Balaram appears as the seventh child in the womb of Vasudev and Devaki in the prison house of Kamsa in Mathura.
Balaram 呢是出现在这个 Vasudev 跟那个家族呢，那是第七个孩子。
The first six children of Devaki were killed by King Kamsa.
Devaki 前面的六个孩子呢被 Kamsa 所杀了。
And after they had departed, then Lord Balaram appears, the seventh child.
那之后是 Balaram 显现呢，是第七个孩子。
And in this way, Lord Balaram shows us how he's fulfilling his mission, that Lord Balaram comes to show all of us how to serve Lord Krishna.
那这 Balaram 的显现的使命呢，是来展示让我们知道要怎么样来服务 Krishna。
Actually, there's no difference between Krishna and Balarama. They are both the personality of Godhead. But the only difference is, you could say, in their color. That Krishna is blackish, whereas Balarama is white.
事实上呢， Krishna 跟 Balarama 是没有分别的，唯一的分别是他们身体的肤色。Krishna 是黑色的， Balarama 是比较蓝的。
So Lord Balaram appears in the womb of Devaki, and as appearing in the womb of Devaki, his purpose is to prepare for the appearance of Lord Krishna, who will come as the eighth child.
那 Balaram 呢，在 Devaki 的腹中啊，子宫中先出来呢，是为了准备这个环境，就是说让 Krishna 之后的显现。
Just as before a king comes, first of all,the ministers will come to make sure everything is ready for the king coming.
就好像呢，一个国王的出现呢，他先出来之前是有他的那一些臣子啦、大宰相这些先出来布局。
So Lord Balaram comes as the seventh child, and he's making sure everything's ready in the womb for the appearance of Lord Krishna there. He makes sure there's a nice bed for Lord Krishna.
所以 Balaram 的出现呢，就是说他要确定呢。这个一切准备好，让 Krishna 之后呢的出现可以都已经有基础了。
Lord Krishna is going to appear in that womb of Devaki, so there should be a nice bed for him to lay on. And Lord Balaram, as his servant, trusted servant, he makes all arrangements for Krishna to come.
因为 Krishna 将会在 Devaki 的腹中呢，就是胎里面呢出现。所以呢 ，Balaram 会先把这些准备好，让 Krishna 可以过来的时候呢，有很舒适的地方可以坐着。
Lord Balaram serves Lord Krishna in many different ways. He expands himself as Anantashesha, and also he expands himself as Sankarshan, and also as the three Purusha avatars.
那 Balaram 呢，他服务 Krishna 的方式有非常多的方式，然后就是说他出现为这个 Ananda Shesha， 还有一个三个化身。
还有 Sankarshan，
还有一个是 Sankarshan。
So the three Purusha avatars, they're doing the work of the manifesting the material world.
那可以巴拉朗他展示一个三个Purusha avatar， 就是主的化身呢，就是来为了创造物质世界所准备的。
Mahasankarshan, he's the resting place for the living entities.
这个 Mahasankarshan 他的出现就是说生物有个居住的地方。
And Anantashesha, he manifests himself in many different forms for the service of Lord Krishna.
那 Anantashesha 呢，他是以各种形体出现来让 Krishna 可以进行他的
下施工。Actually, he appears.Anantashesha takes 10 different forms, all for the service of Lord Krishna.
Anantashesha 展示了十个不同的形体，都是为了让 Krishna 可以进行他要出现的下施工。
Just like we see Lord Narayan laying down on the bed of Anantashesha, so that bed is another form of Lord Balaram.
就好像这个主 Narayan 他还是躺在这 Anantashesha 就是大蛇这个蛇体。那这个呢 ，Anantashesha 也是 Balaram 的扩展。
And then also the shoes and the umbrella of Lord Krishna are forms of Balaram.
还有那 Krishna 的鞋子啦 ，Krishna 的所谓的雨伞啊，这些各种器具呢，
the,
都是 Balaram 的扩展。
The Brahman thread round the neck of Lord Krishna is also a form of Lord Balaram.
然后在 Krishna 身上的婆罗门的圣线呢，也是 Balaram。
And the ornaments which Lord Krishna wears, as well as the clothing which Lord Krishna wears, are all forms of Balaram.
那 Krishna 所带的这些珠宝装饰啊，还有 Krishna 穿的衣服，都是 Balaram 展示出来的。
And Balaram, who expands as Anantashesha, and then Anantashesha takes these 10 different forms.
所以 Balaram 他展示出Anantashesha 展示出十种不同的形体。
That although Lord Balaram is the older brother, he comes in the mood of the servant of Lord Krishna.
虽然 Balaram 他是Krishna 的哥哥，但是他是以仆人的心境出现的。
When he came before as the younger brother in the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra, he was given a lot of difficulties to try to serve the older brother.
先前他出现的时候是成为这个主。Ram 的弟弟，那时候呢，给这个 Ram 带来很多的麻烦。
Lord Rama would not allow his younger brother to make arrangements for his comfort. Lord Rama wanted to do austerity. The younger brother Lakshman was trying to make arrangements for the comfort of Lord Rama. Lord Rama would not allow him. So it was very difficult. It was very painful for Lakshman.
当时呢，巴拉让他展示为这个 Ram 的弟弟是 Lakshman， 那主 Ram 不允许这个 Lakshman 来帮他做安排或服务他，所以这让这个 Lakshman 感觉很为难，他没办法做服务。
So when Lakshman came as in Lord Krishna's pastimes, he comes as Lord Balaram. He doesn't come as a younger brother. He comes as the older brother, and then he can make all arrangements for the service of Krishna.
所以在这一回呢，这个巴拉拉呢，他就不扮演弟弟，他扮演哥哥，这样子他就可以来这个为 Krishna 的出现、Krishna 的活动做准备安排。
So although Lord Balaram appeared in the womb of Devaki, he didn't actually take birth from the womb of Devaki.
虽然呢，巴拉拉是在 Devaki 的所谓胎中出现，但事实上不是说我们一般说的那种肉体出生。
He transferred him by the influence of Yoga Maya. Lord Balaram was transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of another wife of Vasudeva named Rohini.
那这个 Balaram 呢，他利用这个主的内在能量呢，在 Devaki 的腹胎中呢，他自己这个用这个内在能量呢，自己移到这个 Rohini 的这个胎中。
Rohini Nandan means the name of Lord Balaram.One who gives pleasure to Rohini.
So Rohini Nandana 就是说呢，给 Rohini 快乐的人，那也就是指 Balaram 的。
So everyone thought Devaki had a miscarriage because, you know, the child was not you know, they saw she'd lost the child, so they thought, oh, she must have had a miscarriage. But what had happened actually, Lord Balaram had simply been transferred by the power of Yoga Maya into the womb of Rohini.
因为 Devaki 他这个 Balaram 不在他胎中嘛, 所以人家以为他流产了, 因为这个 Balaram 自己用自己的力量呢, 移到这个 Rohini 的胎中了。
So Rohini, we said, she's another wife of Vasudev, and when Vasudev saw that Rohini was pregnant, then for her welfare, for her protection, so that Kamsa would not give her any trouble, Vasudev had Rohini sent to the home of Nanda Maharaj. And she stayed there in the home of Nanda Maharaj and gave birth to Balaram.
So Rohini,
And then, of course, when Krishna appeared in the womb of Devaki, and then he took birth from Devaki's womb, the prison house of Kamsa, and then Vasudev brought the child to the home of Nanda Maharaj. So in this way, both Krishna and Balaram had their childhood pastimes in the home of Nanda Maharaj.
所以呢，这样 Krishna 跟 Balaram 他们孩提时候，小孩，这个就是都在这个 Nanda 大君的家里，这样受到保护。
And they enjoyed being cowherd boys in Vrindavan for their childhood lila.
然后他们就是在 Vrindavan 享受他们这种牧牛童的这一些小时光。
And it was during their childhood lila, Kamsa had sent different demons to try to kill Krishna. And sometimes Krishna will kill them, sometimes Balaram will also kill some demons.
这些恶魔呢，有时候被Krishna所杀掉，有时候被Balaram所杀掉。
Balaram, named Bala, Bala means very strong, and Rama means one who gives pleasure to others.
那Balaram的名字，Bala的意思就是非常强壮的人，那Rama就是说给予别人快乐的人。So
Lord Balaram enjoyed also many wonderful pastimes in the forest with Krishna and the cowherd boys.
对，主巴拉让就享受了很多这些小时光啊，跟这牧牛童们啊，他们在这个森林里面这样。
One time, one great demon came in disguise as a cowherd boy.
有一次有一个恶魔，他自己伪装成那个一个牧牛童。
And he saw Krishna is very powerful. He thought, I don't know if I can defeat Krishna. So he thought he would try his luck with Balaram. So there was a competition, and the coward boys were divided into two sides. So the demon took the side opposing Balaram.
那个时候，有那个恶魔就知道 Krishna 非常有力量，所以他不去挑战 Krishna， 他就去装成是在 Balaram 那一组里面的这个牧牛童，然后这些牧牛童们就分成两批哈，两队这样子。
And they were, the coward boys were playing a game. The side who lost would have to carry the side who won on their back. So Lord Balaram's side won. So he was to be carried on the back of this demon who was disguised as a coward boy.
就这样子，巴拉拉姆赢了啊，然后就是说他赢了，他就可以就是爬到那个恶魔的背上，让这个恶魔背着他。
So the demon thought, I've got Lord Balaram on my back. I'll run off with him. I'll take him, run away with him, and
I'll do something bad to him.
So he had Balaram on his shoulders and he was running. But Lord Balaram holds up, he's very strong because in his form as Anantashesha, he's holding up the universes on his hoods. And the universe is just like a mustard seed on his hood.
因为巴拉拉也是扩展成 Ananda Shesha， 就是说，就是说他把所有的宇宙都在他的支撑里面，所以这些宇宙呢，就好像我们说这个小芝麻啦、小芥末子那么小，对这个主巴拉拉 Ananda Shesha 来讲是太微不足道了。
And so the demon was carrying Lord Balaram, but he was surprised. He was so heavy, it was so heavy, the demon could not carry him. So the demon had to reveal his actual form as a demon. Instead of a cowherd boy, he was a big, huge, strong demon. But even then, he couldn't carry Lord Balaram.
那因为这个 Balaram 呢，他是这么强大有力呢，就是说这个恶魔抬不动了，背不动了，所以那个恶魔就现出原形，他恶魔的样子，他以为他现在变成原来的样子，恶魔一定还是会有很有力量，可是还是这个没办法，扛不起。
And when Balaram saw the cowherd boy was actually a demon, then Lord Balaram just punched him, and the demon fell down dead.
那巴拉拉看到这个被他就是个恶魔，巴拉拉就在一拳咚咚给他揍过去。
So Lord Balaram, his mission is to serve Lord Krishna.
So Balaram 的任务呢是在服务 Krishna.
He comes in Samudra, not as a lord, but he comes as the servant of the Lord. He is therefore the original spiritual master, and all the spiritual masters are they're in the line of coming through from Lord Balaram, who appears in Chaitanya Lila as Lord Nityananda.
所以呢，这个 Balaram 呢，他出现身份不是一个主人或是神的这样的地位身份出现，他是以仆人的身份跟心境出现的。那所以呢，他也是最原始的灵性导师。那所有的灵性导师们呢，又跟随这个巴拉拉，后来在主切坦亚的逍遥时光以尼迦南达身份出现。所有灵性导师是跟随他们这样的教导。
Brajendra Nandana says, "Sachi Sutta Hailahe Balaram Hailo Nitai." The son of Nanda Maharaj comes as the son of Sachi, Lord Chaitanya.And Balaram comes as Lord Nityananda. 嗯，
所以呢 ，Krishna 呢是这个，
Brajendra Nanda, son of Nanda Maharaj.
就是南达大，Krishna 是
the son of Sachi.
Krishna 是南达大君的儿子。后来呢，在全太阳消的时光，他是从 Sachi 母亲那边出现。
And Lord Nityananda is Balaram.
这个在萨奇妈妈这边出现，就是主切坦亚跟尼切南达，尼切南达也就是主巴拉拉。
So we see Lord Balaram, he did not take part in the battle of Kurukshetra. Instead, he decided he wanted to go on pilgrimage.
所以我们看到了这个巴拉拉他没有出现在库鲁这个战场上，他决定他不参与战事，他去朝圣。
And what happened was he went to visit a place called Naimisharanya, where the sages were speaking Srimad Bhagavatam.
Balaram 就去到哪呢？他去到一个森林叫 Naimisharanya， 那时候是这些圣人们在讲述、聆听《薄伽瓦谈》。
So Lord Balaram came into the assembly of all the great sages.And when all the great sages saw Lord Balaram, they all understood he was the personality of Godhead. And they either stood up and offered respects by folding their hands and pranams and bowing their heads, and some even bowed down and offered obeisances.
当 Balaram 到了这个森林这些圣人聚会的现场呢，这些圣人们呢一眼看出来 Balaram 是一个主，或是特别的人物。然后呢，要么站起来拱手对他顶礼，那有一些人呢，就甚至是跟他顶拜。
But one person did not offer respects, and that was Romaharshan Sutta. Romaharshan Sutta was sitting on an elevated seat, and he was addressing all the great sages. But he did not offer any respects to Lord Balaram.
那所有人呢，都起来致敬或是顶拜，那只有一个人 Romaharshan。 他坐在这个高位上，他自己呢就是在好像对大家讲课啦、对大家说话，但是他没有站起来，也没有顶拜。
So Lord Balaram understood that this person is actually proud, that he is not actually qualified to sit on the seat of Vyasadeva.
所以巴拉让看到这个人呢，没有站起来，没有顶拜，就知道这个人其实是一个傲慢的人，所以呢，认为就是说没有资格坐在 Vyasasan。
So Lord Balaram therefore took a blade of kusha grass and pierced his heart and killed him.
那巴拉让呢，就要把他的这个消灭。就拿一根这个茅草、啊、就对着这个 Ramahasa 的心脏这样刺过去，他就死了。
All of the sages were very shocked because they said, you know, we have given Ramahasa the benediction that he would have a long life, and you have killed him.
那所有的圣人们看到这个情况都吓到了，他们说，跟巴拉让说。我们都祝福的 Ramahasa 可以长寿，但是你竟然把他杀了。
Because he was supposed to speak the whole Srimad Bhagavatam to us, so we blessed him to have a long life, so he could finish speaking it. But you've killed him.
那因为呢，他要，因为他要对所有的圣人们讲述薄伽瓦坛，所以需要很长寿，所以我们祝福他长寿。但是呢，现在你竟然把他杀了。
So Lord Balaram said, "Oh, very well. I'll bring him back if you want. I'll bring him back to life."
Balaram 就说，啊，如果你们要的话，你们高兴的话，我就把他起死回生，让他复活。
But the sage said, "No, no. You are the supreme personality of Godhead. You have killed him. We cannot interfere with your decision."
圣人们就说呢，不啊，因为你是至尊主、啊、你的决定就是至尊的决定，所以呢，你要杀掉他，我们就接受，我们不要再怎么样了。
But we've given him the benediction of a long life. So you, what about our benediction? You should keep our benediction intact.
但是呢，我们先前已经祝福他长寿了，那这个部分呢，你应该让我们对他的祝福还是保留着。
So Lord Balaram said, well, he has a son.So his son can take that benediction.
所以巴拉让就说，哦，这个人他还有儿子，让他儿子来接受这个父亲。
The son is not different from the father. So let the son continue speaking in the place of the father. And in this way, Sutta Goswami became the speaker.
所以呢，就是说一个父亲就等于是代表，一个儿子代表父亲，所以呢就让他的儿子来继续讲述这个薄伽瓦坛，他这个儿子就是 Sutta Goswami。
And in this way, Lord Balaram satisfied all the sages.
所以这个情况呢，巴拉让就满足所有的这个圣人们了。
And there was also some Rakshasa who was disturbing the sages there, and but they asked Lord Balaram.Please help us. Please kill this demon who's troubling us.
那当场也有一些罗刹哈，很多罗刹，他们一直在制造干扰哈，所以呢，他们也很期望说，这个主可以把这个刚刚那个恶魔杀掉。
So in this way, Lord Balaram shows us how he has come, just like Lord Krishna, to establish the religious principles.To give pleasure to his devotees and kill the miscreants.
所以这个情况呢，就是说巴拉让也像 Krishna 一样的展示的出现呢，把这恶魔杀掉，然后来取悦他的这些奉献者，这样子。
Now Lord Balaram has his favorite beverage. He's very fond of drinking Varuni, which is a nectarian drink, something like honey.And usually on this day, we will usually always offer some honey. We should tell them, don't get it, you know? Yeah.
那巴拉让很喜欢有一个特别的甘露，那这基本上是很接近蜂蜜这种甘露，所以在传统上这一天为对巴拉让特别这个供奉这个。
So, Balaram likes to drink this Varuni, and when he drinks it, sometimes he will become intoxicated by it. Just like if you take too much sugar or too much honey, you know, then you can become intoxicated.
那这个巴拉拉没有说这个喝了很多很多，就像醉了一样，就像有人吃了、很多糖果甜的，吃太过多了，或是喝了很多蜂蜜呢，他会类似超级过动啊，过到疯狂，动到疯狂那种状态。
So Lord Balaram had been drinking a lot of honey one day, and he was on the banks of the Yamuna, and he was some distance from the Yamuna, but while he was intoxicated, he decided he wanted to bathe in the Yamuna, and he ordered the Yamuna River, come here, you come to me.
有一次呢，巴拉拉姆是喝了这个瓦鲁尼这个甘露，喝了很多，就好像醉昏昏的，所以他又想去这个亚穆纳河去沐浴，所以他就在那边岸边看着亚穆纳河说：“你过来，你过来。”
But nothing happened. The Yamuna didn't move.
他这么喊着的时候，亚穆纳河也没有动啊。
So Lord Balaram then took his plow, and he began to hit the ground.And he said, I'm going to break the Yamuna into little streams.
那巴拉拉看到亚穆纳河都没动，还是留在那里啊，所以巴拉拉就拿起他那个棒槌跟那个处理啊，这个我要把你分成很多很多的小水啊，什么小河流这样子。
When Lord Balaram did that, immediately the demigoddess of the Yamuna River came out from the bottom of the Yamuna River and offered her obeisances to Lord Balaram.
当这个主巴拉要这么做的时候，这个半神人们呢，赶快跟那个亚穆纳说，赶快呢，这个亚穆纳和女神呢，就赶快从那个亚穆纳河底出现了，来跟主巴拉让顶拜。
And she apologized to Lord Balaram that I'm very sorry, I didn't understand your identity. Now I know my mistake. Please forgive me.
那这个亚穆纳就跟巴拉姆说啊，非常抱歉，我不知道你的身份啊，先请对你这么傲慢啊，对不起。
So one of the names of Lord Balaram is Hala Dara, which means the carrier of the plow.
所以巴拉姆还有另外一个名字叫 Hala Dara, 就是说他带着这个处理的人。
Lord Balaram actually has two weapons. One is the club, and the other is the plow.
巴拉拉实际上有两个武器，一个是他这个处理，一个是那个神碟。
神碟。
Club.
Club. Yeah. Not 神碟。Citizen chakra.
Chakra.
神碟。Yes, this. Not 神碟。That's citizen chakra. Club.
棒槌。
棒槌。
一个是，两个都是这样子，锄，也是像锄头的。
So,
一个锄头，一个是棒槌。
So Lord Balaram is very expert in fighting with the club.
这个巴拉拉姆是很擅长用棒槌来打架、打战。
And one of his students was Duryodhan, and Duryodhan learned how to fight with the club. Duryodhan became very expert in fighting with the club.
那巴拉拉姆有一个学生，他有一个门徒就是 Duryodhan, 所以 Duryodhan 也是很擅长来这个玩耍棒槌。
So he was so, Duryodhan was so expert that Bhima, who was very strong, he also fought with the club, but Bhima couldn't defeat Duryodhan. They were fighting with each other. Duryodhan was very skillful and Bhima was very strong. Neither could win.
那 Bhima 也是跟这个 Duryodhan 一起对抗，他们一起打战。这个 Bhima 是很有力量，但是呢Duryodhana 是对棒槌的这个技巧很熟练，所以他们两个互打呢，一直不分上下。
So Lord Balaram told them, you shouldn't fight. It's not, you won't get a result. You won't be able to fight each other because, you know, one of you is more skillful, the other is more strong. Nobody will win. You're wasting your time to fight each other. So Lord Balaram went away.
很好玩，巴拉拉姆就跟他们两个说，你们两个不要打了啦，你们永远分不出输赢，你们一个力量很大，另外一个是技巧很好，所以你们一直打一定一直都会不分上下，所以你们在浪费时间，巴拉拉姆说着就走掉了。
That was when Lord Balaram went for his pilgrimage, you know, he thought he could avoid getting in all the battle and fighting. But then when he went to Naimisharanya, he saw he still had to deal with the Jiro Maharsha.
那巴拉让他离开这个库卢战场，是想避开战事，他不想参与战争。但是他到南蛮沙拉尼亚森林的时候呢，就碰到这个人呢，如果他是这么恶劣啊，这么傲慢，所以他不得不出来消灭这个。
So he said he took the blade of Kusha grass and he pierced that heart of Roma Harsha.
我们刚刚说到呢，巴拉让拿起这个一根茅草，就往这个 Roma Harsha 的心脏这个位置刺过去，让他病致命。
But when Lord Balaram came in the Kali Yuga as Lord Nityananda, he took that Kusha grass between his mouth. That's a sign of humility. And he fell at the feet of the people and requested them all to chant the holy name.
但是主巴拉让在这个卡利年代出现是Nityananda, 但是主 Nityananda 就把那个茅草呢是含在嘴里。这个代表就是说一个很谦卑人容忍一切啊，他把这个茅草那个尖那个茅草尖边边是尖尖的。
We see how Lord Balaram changed that in the Kali Yuga he comes as Lord Nityananda and he goes door to door to everyone to request them to chant the holy name and to worship Krishna and read the books about Krishna.
所以我们就看到这个 Balaram 是怎么样的改变，他到了。这个主尼恰南达的时候呢，他挨家挨户的去祈求别人念诵圣名啊，去荣耀圣名这样子。
And even when he went to the two drunkards, Jagai and Madhai, and they became violent and they struck him on the head, but Lord Nityananda he was so tolerant, he begged Lord Chaitanya, don't kill them.
那甚至呢，主巴拉拉姆的，就是尼恰南达遇到那两个。恶棍醉鬼呢，这个加盖跟马盖呢，他们这样冒犯他，还用那个破瓦片丢他的头啊，流血，他还要请求主陈太阳妈宝宝原谅这两个恶棍。
So quite a different mood from Lord Balaram who's in Dwapara Yuga, and then when Lord Balaram comes in this Kali Yuga, he's very merciful and he's very forgiving, tolerant.
所以呢。这个是那么大的差别。主巴拉姆在杜拉帕年代出现的时候是这样子代表有力的，那这个时候到卡利年代呢，代表这么谦卑、仁慈这样子原谅的。
And another interesting pastime of Lord Balaram was when one of Krishna's children, Samba, one of Krishna's grandchildren actually, Samba.Went to the Swayamvara ceremony of the daughter of Duryodhana, Lakshmana. Lakshmana, the daughter of Duryodhana, was to pick her husband, and Samba went for the ceremony.
好，还有一个情况就是说呢，巴拉让他到了这个 Duryodhana 的这个女儿那边呢。Lakshmana， 他就说要挑选丈夫啊，那时候那个。这个谁的儿子啊 ？Samba， 他出现，他想要说被挑成变成他女婿。
So this woman Lakshmana was supposed to pick the husband she wanted. Many kings, many princes had all come, you know. And Samba was thinking, you know, I would like her for my wife. So he also thought she's not going to pick me. She's going to pick somebody else.
那三巴他到了那个所谓这个选婚现场呢，他是想说呢，希望把这个 Lakshmana 成为他的老婆，但是他心里又知道这个 Lakshmana 不会选中，不会去选他。
So when he saw her, Samba just simply picked her up and ran off with her.
三巴一到现场就直接把人抓了，就把这个 Lakshmana 抓着就离开现场了。
All the princes, all the kings were all angry and they all chased after Samba. He was running away. He captured, you know, this young woman for his wife. And he ran away, but they all chased after him and they captured him.
因为那个现场呢，满满是那些王公贵族啦，国王啊，公子啊，还有甚至是圣人啊，他们要被挑选。那这个时候大家一阵惶恐，就追着这个 Samba 跑，因为他把 Lakshmana 带走了，大家很惊慌的追着跑。
So they captured Samba and they put him in the prison.
所以大家就把三把抓到，然后把他丢到监狱里去。
So Narada Muni went to Dwarka and told Lord Krishna what had happened, and Lord Krishna was ready to come with an army and to make war against him.
那这个就 Narada Muni 就到了 Dwarka， 然后看到这个情况呢，然后呢就是说要防要阻止这件事呢，因为刚刚说三把是 Krishna 的孙子啊，所以要阻止刚刚那个情况。
But Balaram said, no, no, Duryodhana is my friend. I can go there. I will settle it peacefully. There's no need to make war.
然后这个Balaram 就说不用了不用了，因为这个 Duryodhana 是我的朋友，我可以去处理这件事，你们就不用出来了。
So Balaram went there to meet Duryodhana. And when Balaram came outside the palace of Duryodhana, then Duryodhana came out to receive him.He was very happy, and they arranged a big reception for Lord Balaram. You know, they were very pleased that Lord Balaram has come as their guest. They knew Balaram is their friend.
那这个 Balaram 就到 Duryodhana 的宫殿那边去，然后 Duryodhana 看到 Balaram 来，非常的高兴，弄得很盛大的欢迎他，接待他，因为他们好就像老朋友啊，又这么好。
So then Lord Balaram told them why he's come. He said, you know, I hear you've got Krishna's grandson Samba in your prison house, and that he's already taken your daughter Lakshmana for his wife. So you should release him and give his wife also. I want to take them back to Dwarka with me.
所以巴拉拉姆就跟这个德欧达尔说呢，你知道呢，桑巴是 Krishna 的孙子啊，那现在他把你女儿 Lakshmana 带走了，成为他的老婆。可是你现在把他们关在监狱里，请你把他放了，我要把他们两个带回去。
And so then Duryodhana became angry. They said, "Oh, you've come here to tell us what to do, is it? You're Krishna. He's just a cowherd boy. He's no prince. He doesn't have a kingdom."Who is he to tell us what to do?
那德尔达尔就一副傲慢呢，一副很不屑的，就是说，哦，就对巴拉拉姆说，你呀，你为了这件事来啊，你 Krishna 他算什么？他只是一个在放牛的，他哪里有什么地方，有什么宫殿，他有什么资格，就是说叫我这个女儿是公主哈，然后把你他的孙子这样带走。
We are the royal family. We have the empire. We have the palace. We have the kingdom. You people, you're nobody. Who are you to tell us what to do?
Duryodhana 又继续说，我们是皇家贵族啊，哎，我们有我们的皇宫啊什么的。你们是什么？你们有什么？你还叫我？你还过来跟我说我要怎么做啊？
You people are just like the shoes, but you want to go on our head.
Shoes.
Shoes, yeah.
那主要当然说，你们这些就好像那个鞋子一样，你还想爬到我们头上？你们是那个人家踩在地上的鞋哈，还爬到我们头上
？So when Lord Balaram heard them speaking this way so insultingly and not giving proper respect to Lord Krishna, then Lord Balaram said, "I can see you people are just like animals."
巴拉拉姆看到这主要当然这么说呢，对 Krishna 这么不尊敬，所以巴拉拉姆就说。我看你们这些呢，只是一些禽兽。
Animal. So with animals, you don't give good instructions. Good animals can't understand what is a good instruction. Animals, the only thing they can understand is a stick. So he said, now I will have to deal with you like I deal with animals.
你们这些就是禽兽啊，一些动物啦，你们动物啊，哎，好话听不懂。所以这个管教动物就是只有用棍子、竹子，所以我现在就给你们拿根棍子管一管。
So Lord Balaram took his plow and he began to pull the whole Hastinapur palace into the Yamuna.
那个 Balaram 就拿起他那个棒槌呢，就把这个宫殿叫 Hastinapur 整个拉拉拉，然后把它拉到 Yamuna 河去。
And when Duryodhana and all the other people from Duryodhana's palace, when they saw the palace moving into the Yamuna, then they understood and they fell at Lord Balaram's feet, said, no, no, just wait, we're going to bring them. We will bring Samba, we will bring his wife.
那 Balaram 呢就看Duryodhana 看到 Balaram 这个样子，把他整个宫殿可以这样子，他一个棒槌就把整个全部的宫殿拉过去了，所以他就知道他的厉害，然后就赶快跟他对不起啊，对不起，我现在这个样子。
So they immediately released Samba and Lakshmana, and they brought a dowry and they sent them all back with Lord Krishna to Lord Krishna. And they told Lord Balaram, we were only testing you. We just wanted to see some display of your power. No, Duryodhana said like, to Balaram.
Now, 后来呢，这个 Duryodhana 就把这个 Samba 还有这个 Lakshmana 释放，同时呢，准备很丰富的嫁妆哈、啊，让他这个女儿这样跟着这个 Samba 一起回去到 Balaram Krishna 那边的宫殿去。
So you see how Lord Balaram serves Lord Krishna.
所以我们就看、
so nice.
看到 Balaram 是怎么样的这么好的服务着 Krishna.
When Lord Krishna left Vrindavan.The gopis in Vrindavan were all missing Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna sent Lord Balaram back to Vrindavan to pacify the minds of all the Vrijvasi.
When Krishna 离开了 Vrindavan 的时候，这个所有的牧牛姑娘都非常的伤心难过啊。那 Krishna 就派 Balaram 回到 Vrindavan 去安慰那些牧牛姑娘。
Lord Balaram came back and.Could tell them all about Lord Krishna and how Lord Krishna is remembering all the people, all his devotees in Vrindavan.
So Balaram 呢就啊派得到 Krishna 的指示，到了回到 Vrindavan， 告诉牧牛姑娘嘛，就是说呢 ，Krishna 在那边现在的状况啊，这样来安慰这些牧牛姑娘。
But Lord Balaram never has any relationship or any contact with Srimati Radharani.Srimati Radharani is the property of Lord Krishna.
当然呢，虽然跟 Krishna 这么亲近 ，Balaram 从来没有跟 Radharani 有任何的接触，因为他认为这个 Radharani 是属于 Krishna 的。
Wherever Krishna is with Srimati Radharani, then Lord Balaram will not be there.
只要呢 ，Krishna 跟 Radharani 在一起的时候呢，这 Balaram 他自己就会隐退。
And when Krishna is with Balaram, then Srimati Radharani will never be there.
好，当 Krishna 跟 Balaram 在一起的时候 ，Radharani 也不会出现。
So Lord Balaram also has two wives. One, we said he is very fond of Varuni, so Varuni drink. One of his wives is called Varuni.
那我们知道 Balaram 有两个老婆，那因为 Balaram 非常喜欢这 Varuni 那种蜂蜜甘露，所以他其中一个老婆也叫做 Varuni。
And the other wife is called Revati. She's the daughter of a great king, Revata.
那另外一个老婆叫 Revati， 这个 Revati 是他父亲是一个伟大的国王 Revata。
Maharaj Revata appeared in the Treta Yuga.
这个Revata 这个国王在特塔年代的时候出现。
And so he had this nice daughter, and he was wondering who she should marry. So he decided he would take her with him, and they would go to see Lord Brahma in Brahmaloka, and ask Lord Brahma who will be the best husband for his daughter.
Revata 这个伟大的国王就这个女儿要出嫁的事，就在想说，我这么好的女儿，到底要。嫁给谁呢？所以他就带着女儿一起到这个婆罗诃摩梵天的星球去询问这个婆罗诃摩。
So they got to Brahmaloka, but they were informed you have to wait. Lord Brahma is listening to a musical concert just now.
那他那个 Revata 带着女儿 Revati 到了这个 Brahma 的星球那儿去，那守门跟他说：“你们必须等一等，因为我们这个梵天婆罗诃摩正在听音乐会。”
Yeah, when the musical concert is finished, then you can see Lord Brahma.
所以当那个音乐会结束的时候，你们就可以去见 Krishna.
So they had to wait, and they were waiting, and after some time, the concert finished, and they were taken to meet Lord Brahma.
所以他们就必得在门外等啊等啊，那等到这音乐会结束的时候，他们才有办法见到这个梵天婆罗诃摩。
So Maharaj Revata, the king, the father of the girl, he said to Lord Brahma that, I want you to tell me which of these kings will be the good husband for my daughter.
所以 Revata 就对梵天说了，我要问你，就是说。哪一个国王或是哪一个王子适合当我女儿的丈夫
？So he mentioned the king mentioned the names of some other different men, princes and kings, so he thought might be suitable for his daughter. But when Lord Brahma heard these names, Lord Brahma laughed. He said, these people are all dead long ago.
So this Rebhaka, this king, just talked about several people's names. This Fan Ting heard, he laughed. He said, you say these people are long ago, and these people are dead.
So Maharaj Rebhaka was surprised. He said, but what? They were not dead when I was just there on earth. They were not dead then. But Lord Brahma said, yes, but you've been waiting here. You waited here for me. While you were waiting here, many, many years passed on the earth planet, because the time on the Brahma Loka, one moment, is like 1 year on the earth planet. So while you were waiting here, all of these kings, they've all gone. They've all died, and many, their generations have all come and gone.
所以呢，这梵天就对瑞巴塔这个国王说了，你在这里记不记得刚刚等了一段时间了？然后呢，这个国王说，对呀，可是你说为什么说他们迟了？我来之前我还知道他们活着啊，我还见到他们。那这个梵天跟他说，你在这边的时间，你知道我这边星球的瞬间就等于地球上的一年，何况你们等了一段时间，那些人呢早就死了。
So then Lord, the king said, well, what about my daughter? She needs to get a husband.
这个国王就说, 那我女儿怎么办? 她必须要有个丈夫啊。
So Lord Brahma said, well, you go back to earth now. The personality of Godhead, Lord Brahma, Lord Balaram is there rather. He's the personality of Godhead. He will make a good husband for your daughter.
然后这个梵天波罗赫摩就跟瑞巴达说：“好，你现在再回到地球去。你现在呢，回去呢，这个巴拉姆正在那里。巴拉姆很适合你女儿啊，就是说他可以是你女儿的很好的丈夫。”So
the king came back with his daughter and presented her to Lord Balaram.
所以这个国王带着女儿回到地球来，然后呢，把女儿带到这个巴拉姆面前。But
there was a problem because this king and his daughter. They were from the previous age. So in the previous age, people were much taller. So this girl was much taller than Lord Balaram.
但是有个问题，因为这个瑞巴达国王跟他的女儿是属于先前的年代，先前人是非常高大，所以这个女孩呢就比巴拉姆高了很多。So
Lord Balaram took his plow. And brought her down to size.
Balaram 又拿起他棒槌敲敲他，让他这个女儿又身高没有那么高了。And
this way, Lord Balaram has two wives. These two girls, these two wives, they came again. And Lord Nityananda's pastimes. Lord Nityananda also had two wives.
所以这两个这个 Balaram 的这个老婆呢，到了这个我们卡利年代，这个主尼查南达显现的时候，他们也一起显现。所以主尼查南达也有两个老婆。
Yeah, Lord Nityananda married the two daughters of Sanatan Mishra, Janava and Vasuni.
So,
这个Sanatan Mishra的两个女儿，有一个是Janava，一个是Vasudha，跟Janava两个。Two wives, the two sisters, the same two wives Lord Balaram came again.
他们这个两个姐妹呢，都成为Balaram的这个老婆。Okay,
so we still have 5 minutes. Any questions about Lord Balaram?
五分钟，有没有任何问题关于Balaram的情况？Lord
Balaram kills also demons like a Dravidago gorilla. Dravida gorilla, he was actually involved in the Ramayana and the Battle of Lanka, fought for Lord Ram with the monkeys, but he became degraded.
Balaram also killed this big monkey, this big monkey, this big monkey in the Ram Ramachandra 的夏尔时光里面呢，他也参与，就是说到斯里兰卡那一段，就是说救西塔的过程。但是他后来堕落了，所以到这个巴拉拉这个时候，他已经堕落变成恶魔了，所以被巴拉拉所杀除。
So Lord Balaram, he has to establish the religious principles. People are not obedient to the religious principles, then Lord Balaram, he would remove them.
所以呢，巴拉拉他出现也是要建立宗教原则，对于非宗教人士啊，非宗教原则他会来去去除的。
And in his form as Ananta Shesha.He's always describing the glories of the qualities of Lord Krishna.
当他身为Ananta Shesha 这个大蛇形的时候呢，他总是在这个赞扬主 Krishna 的荣耀。
All the different planets are resting on the hoods of Ananta Shesha.
所有的这些不同的星球都躺在哪里呢？躺在这个 Ananta Shesha 这个大蛇很多头的这个。
Ananta Shesha has many many hoods, and each of these hoods has mouths, and each of these mouths are reciting the pastimes of Lord Krishna, and they're all reciting different pastimes.
那 Ananta Shesha 是很多头的蛇哈，那它每一个头都有一个嘴。每一个嘴都在一直在唱诵着、朗诵着 Krishna 的逍遥时光，所以呢，这个很多很多的 Krishna 的逍遥时光都同时被朗诵着。
And they're never repeating, and they're never short of things to say. They're going on describing the pastimes of Lord Balaram endlessly.
而且呢，他们永不停止的在荣耀着这个 Krishna Balaram 的逍遥时光。这个他们这么多个头哈，这个嘴都一直在上荣耀着。
So you can see from Lord Balaram how to serve Lord Krishna.
所以要看到这巴拉姆是怎么样服务 Krishna.
Lord Balaram serves Lord Krishna in all the different rasas.
巴拉姆呢有去服务 Krishna 有很多的不同的这种关系或是品味。
Sometimes.Balaram will be massaging Krishna like a servant of Krishna.
有时候巴拉姆呢为 Krishna 按摩，就像仆人呢为主人按摩。
And we said also Lord Balaram went to Vrindavan to pacify, to console the people of Vrindavan, delivering news about Lord Krishna.
还有就是说巴拉姆呢，他被派到回到这个 Vrindavan 呢，去把 Krishna 的讯息传到 Vrindavan 去安抚 Vrindavan 的居民。
Sometimes Balaram is the friend of Krishna, and they're together, just like friends, just like equals, they play with each other.
那有时候呢，巴拉姆呢，他扮演 Krishna 像朋友啊，然后就跟朋友这样平等的，就是说在玩啊，在做事啊，这样平等。
And sometimes Balaram is like the father. Sometimes he's, you know, he's caring, protecting Krishna.
那巴拉姆是哥哥，但是有时候他就像一个父亲一样，他就在照顾着这个孩子，这样子照顾着 Krishna.
And also in the form of Ananga Manjari, he's in the conjugal ras in the Mudra conjugal ras.
那巴拉姆是 Ananga Manjari 这个牧牛姑娘的时候，他跟 Krishna 的感情就是那个爱侣伴侣的感情。
So Balaram serving Krishna in all these different ras.
所以巴拉拉姆是以这么多种不同的关系在服务着 Krishna.
But especially in the mood of Dasya and Satya, servant and friendship.
那在他那种多种的关系里面，最特别就是朋友跟仆人这两种关系。
So we are praying to Lord Balaram today on this auspicious day in this auspicious month of Sarat, on the day of the full moon, on the day in which Lord Balaram appeared.We're praying to him, please be merciful to us, help us to develop some love for Krishna. As you serve Krishna, please bless us that we can also serve Lord Krishna.
所以呢，在这个巴拉姆显现这个月圆的时候，满月的时候呢，我们向他祈祷，就是说祈求巴拉姆让我们学习像他这样去服务 Krishna, 去取悦 Krishna.
Okay, any questions?Sivananda Prabhu, you want to say anything, Prabhu?
No, I did, and then you covered it later.
There's one pastime. Prabhupada asked, who's strongest, Krishna or Balaram, right?
曾经有一个情况， Prabhupada 就问大家说 Krishna 还是 Balaram 哪一个比较有力量？
Right. So,
有谁可以回答谁比较强？
You can see from this picture on the altar, you can see Krishna and Balaram's picture there. You see Lord Balaram's leaning on Krishna. So it means Krishna must be strongest because he's holding up Balaram.
所以你想啊 Krishna 或是 Balaram 哪一个比较强？那这个神坛上的图片看到呢，这个巴拉让就是手靠在 Krishna 的肩膀上，这样哈撑着靠着，然后就知道呢，他有这么大的力量，所以 Krishna 是比较强的。
But Lord Balaram, well, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he would not let people lean against the temple wall.
那 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur 呢，他不允许人在庙里面这样靠着墙啊，赖在墙。
Because that's Balaram.
Because
holding the roof up over the temple, the deities. Okay, Lord Balaram Purnima Mahotsava ki.
Jai.
Lord Balarama ki.
Jai.
Shri Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Lord Premanand.
Isolines Nashinga Maharaj ki.
Jai.